हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू आर डूइंग ग्रेट एंड यू मस्ट बी टेकिंग गुड केयर ऑफ योर सेल्फ बाय स्टेइंग एट होम। सो टुडे लेट्स स्टार्ट हिस्ट्री चैप्टर 5, रूलर्स एंड बिल्डिंग्स। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द सेशन 1। इन मिडिवल पीरियड रूलर्स बिल्ट प्राइवेट एंड पब्लिक बिल्डिंग्स लाइक फोर्ट्स, पैलेसेस, टोम्स, टेम्पल्स, मॉस्क, टैंक्स एक्सेट्रा। So let's start with the first topic, engineering skills and construction. Monuments provide an insight into the technologies used for construction. Between the 7th and 10th centuries, architects started adding more rooms, doors and windows to building. Roofs, doors and windows were made by placing a horizontal beam across two vertical columns, a style of architecture called trebuchet or corbelette. The two technological and stylistic developments from the 12th century are arcuate architectural forms and used of limestone mixed with stone chips that led to faster construction. Assimilation of Indian style with Persian style of architecture was prominent. Buildings, temple, mosques and tanks. Temples and mosques are beautifully constructed because they were places of worship and meant to demonstrate the power, wealth and devotion of the patron. The largest temples were all constructed by kings. The other lesser deities in the temples were gods and goddesses of the allies and subordinates of the ruler. Muslim sultans and padshahs did not claim to be incarnation of God, but Persian court chronicles described the sultan as the shadow of God. As each new dynasty came to power, kings wanted to emphasize their moral rights to be rulers. It was widely believed that the rule of a just king would be an age of plenty when the heavens would not withhold rain. Why were temples destroyed? Since kings built temples to demonstrate their devotion to God and their power and wealth, they attacked and targeted these buildings when they attacked one another's kingdom. In the early 11th century, when the Chola king Rajendra I built a Shiva temple in his capital, he filled it with prized statues seized with defeated rulers. Gardens, tombs and forest. Under the Mughal, architecture became more complex. Babur, Humayun, Akbar, Jahangir and Shahjahan were personally interested in literature, art and architecture. Babur got gardens called Charbagh, four gardens, built in Kabul. They were further constructed in Kashmir, Agra and Delhi by Akbar, Jahangir and Shahjahan. Akbar's architecture is visible in his father's Humayun's tomb. Under Shahjahan, Mughal architecture was fused together in a grand harmonious synthesis. The ceremonial halls of the public and private audience, Diwane Khas, Diwane Aam, were carefully planned. Shahjahan adapted the Charbagh technique in the layout of the Taj Mahal, the grandest architectural accomplishment of his region. A construction activity increased between the 8th and the 18th centuries. There was also a considerable sharing of idea across the region. In Vijayanagar, for example, the elephant stables of the rulers were strongly influenced by the style of architecture found in the adjoining sultanates of Bijapur and Golconda. In Vrindavan near Mathura, temples were constructed in architectural styles that were very similar to the Mughal palaces in Fatehpur Sikri. The creation of large empires that brought different regions under their rule helped in the cross-fertilization of artistic forms and architectural style. Mughals adopted the Bangla dome in their architecture. This is where we end with the session 2. I hope the topics covered in this session were understood by you. As usual, I will advise you to read textbook, write the hard words in your notebook, watch the video carefully, listen to it, listen to the pronunciation, and read the slides for your better understanding. So I hope the topics are clear. So see you in the second session. Till then, stay home, stay safe, take care of yourself. Bye-bye.